1 year later, the rebuilding continues. We dodged a bullet, but the Jersey Shore took the brunt of Superstorm Sandy. A year ago, we showed just how bad it was when 11 News I-Team lead investigative reporter Jayne Miller visited by helicopter.
Yeah, Jayne, whose family has owned a home there for years and years, went back last week for a progress report. And amid all the recovery, the fight for some people is now about property rights.
It was a chilly, rainy day on the Jersey Shore when we visited last week, but that didn't matter to Bill Demchek and Donna Kramer. They'd rented an oceanfront house for the week.
We're just loyal Jersey people, and Jersey Shore is the bomb. We just always came down this way.
My grandfather's had a place here since the 50s, you know, and that's what I enjoy, coming down here.
Even now, they say, a year after Superstorm Sandy tore up the Jersey Shore, with such force, her calling cards still dominate the landscape.
If you see those houses over there, these houses here had 4 feet of sand around it and about 2 feet of sand in the houses.
Ken Sisnicki, a builder, is currently working on an area at Normandy Beach that burned last year due to Sandy's wrath. We took these pictures of the area during a helicopter visit last year. Today, the charred pilings of one house remain, another property is under construction, and this one's been raised up, awaiting further decisions by its owner.
We lifted that house and moved it back because that foundation was, everything was washed out from the foundation. That man's beachfront decks were in everybody's yard. It was tremendous, you know, damage-wise. And people just don't realize it because, and you know, it's a year later, a lot of people forget. You know, this is going to take a long time.
This is what Maniloking looked like a year ago. The ocean carved new inlets, wiping away 20 homes in this spot and cutting off Route 35, the island's main road. Today, that same area has been cleared, a retaining wall is in place, and one property owner has begun reconstruction. But the town's offices are still in temporary quarters a few miles inland. The town lost a third of its homes, and the town is fighting with some of its property owners. They don't want to give up rights to their oceanfront land so a new dune can be built. Last week, the town council voted to take the land through eminent domain.
So we're not actually taking the property and going to build something or steal it from somebody. We're not going to take their homes. We're going to take the area in front, very defined area, and we're going to put a lot of sand on it.
The fight is brewing all along the Jersey Shore post-Sandy. Holdout owners don't want to lose their view.
The beauty of the beachfront property is that you get to wake up, stretch, and see the ocean. If you get to wake up, stretch, and see a bunch of sand dunes, it's not as aesthetically pleasing, and the values, I would say, somewhat lower.
Work here to repair roads and infrastructure is far from complete. Some houses damaged by Sandy remain untouched. Others are still being demolished. New ones, like my family's home, are being built on pilings. Sandy's legacy is changing the Jersey Shore, but the locals insist not its people.
I know that early in the storm, especially, I'm one of them, but senior citizens said, oh, I can't do this, I'm going to sell, I'm going to leave. Most of the ones that I know personally have all changed their mind. They're fixing and they're coming back. If you love the beach and you love the ocean, it gets in your blood. People don't leave.
I'm Jayne Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.